Hello and welcome to Britain's Got Talent, the show which sets out to find Britain's best new act and give them a truly incredible prize.
Tonight we'll be asking the people of Birmingham if they've got talent, but how will they answer?
Oh, I don't know. I guess they'll probably say something like, "Oh yes, Ed, we've got loads and loads of great brummy talent here in Birmingham."
What?
Not my words, Ant. Probably the words of the people of Birmingham.
Well, you can tell the people of Birmingham to shut up.
All right, well, they're not going to like it.
Yes, the people of Birmingham have turned up in their droves, and there's everything from dancers to dog acts and even fire breathers. The winner of this competition will win £100,000 and get the chance to perform at the Royal Variety Performance.
All of the acts will have to perform in front of our judges.
Three showbiz giants.
Music mogul Simon Cowell.
You just want to find one act, and then I'd love to watch the Royal Variety and see whoever that is get a standing ovation.
Star of stage and screen Amanda Holden.
The thing I want to find is something that would never normally get the opportunity to perform, that we can change their life, we can make their dreams come true. That's what I'm looking for.
And one of the most talked about journalists of our time, Piers Morgan.
I'm hoping to unearth an act that doesn't just wow us, but wows the Royal Variety Show, wows the Queen, and goes on to have a 20-year career in show business. Then I would think that we had really, really done a great job.
Three people who do not suffer fools gladly. That's why we don't let Ant anywhere near them.
Yeah.
They each have a buzzer in front of them. When they press that buzzer, their corresponding X turns red. When an act gets three red X's, that's it, time's up. An audition is over. Now it's time to hand over to some of the finest performers in the Midlands. Take it away, Birmingham.
I've got talent.
The first act facing the judges, and not forgetting the 1,000-strong audience, is 51-year-old school caretaker John Shaw.
So, who's this little fella?
This is Jack.
Hello, Jack.
Hello, Jack. How are you?
I'm okay.
I'd like to be a well-known ventriloquist, so when I go out, people just stop me in the street and say, "Oh, I saw you on telly. You were brilliant."
Do you think you've got what it takes to win this show?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Right, your name is?
John. My name's John and this is Jack.
Okay, and how long have you been doing this for, John?
3 weeks.
I would have been tempted to lie.
Yeah. I would have kept 3 weeks to myself and said 7 years, 10 years, all my life. Yeah.
All right. Do you honestly believe, with the limited time you've had, that you could win this competition?
Yeah.
Yeah?
We can't we, Jack?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see your act, please.
This is Jack. I call him Jack because I found him under a car. Do you know, up to the age of 13, he thought his name was Shut Up.
He's dying out there, isn't he?
He went out to play snooker last night. How'd you go out at snooker? I couldn't get in, the queues were too long.
You can see his mouth move.
Once the audience turn, there's no going back, really, is there?
Oh, they're a bit wicked out there, aren't they, Jack?
Yeah, give us a chance.
Yeah. Can I come and do it?
Sounds like a cat who's cornered a mouse and is just playing with him.
John, you may have only been doing this for 3 weeks, but you are the worst ventriloquist in the world. Believe it or not, the idea of doing this is you don't open your mouth. In fact, your mouth was open wider than the dummies. All right. Piers, yes or no?
No.
Amanda?
No.
You're lovely, but you're rubbish.
So no, thank you very much. You are cruel.
I won't see you again, Jack. It's back in the box for you.
Yeah.
But, see you on eBay, Jack.
Yeah, see you on eBay. Bye.
So John and Jack are the first buzzer casualties of the day.
And it looks like the judges are sending their fingers into overdrive.
What's brought you here today?
Monologues, comedy songs, a whole variety act.
Do you want to do it?
A short monologue entitled Orange Peel.
Yes or no?
It's no.
What are you going to do for us today?
I'm going to make you laugh. I broke down on the M6. I don't know what came over me, really. I just burst into tears.
Oh, come on, give an old girl a chance.
Sweetheart, you would have been old-fashioned 50 years ago. Watching you kick nothing is sort of pointless.
What do you do, Joy?
I'm a millionaire motivator.
Right, and you're going to do an act which shows us how to be a millionaire?
Yes, basically.
Off you go.
So, you want to be a millionaire?
Are you a millionaire?
That's a good question.
Yes or no?
I've got the lifestyle.
Are you a millionaire?
That's for me to know, for you to find out.
Amanda?
I don't think the Queen needs to know how to be a millionaire.
No.
So no.
No, it's a no, sweetheart. Thank you.
Well, it has to be said that Britain has got talent.
It's just that none of it has decided to turn up in Birmingham today.
Hoping to turn the tide are seven best friends from Coventry who are searching for a better life. They share a dream to become a professional dance crew.
This group is called the Combat Breakers. Because we're all best mates and we're really close and tight, it's really good. We range from 13 all the way up to, I'm the oldest, 25. Our main love is dancing. That's what we do. That's what we sleep, eat, breathe. That's our main thing, to make this our career for life, do you know what I mean? So we can quit the 9-to-5 jobs and all that sort of stuff. This is the dream team right here, Combat Breakers.
That sounded heavy, isn't it?
Now, work the shoulders, work the shoulders.
On you guys.
Enjoy it.
Who are you guys? Where are you from?
My name's Leroy, this is my crew. We're called the Combat Breakers and we hail from Coventry.
Do you think you've got the talent to win?
Today, we're going to show the world that Britain has got talent!
Okay.
Really like them. I could do that. I just don't want to. It's easy, man.
Never going to say that I'm an expert on this, because I'm not. Having said that, I think that one of the reasons for being on this panel is to try and guess what a mainstream audience are going to love. And I can tell you, I absolutely loved what I saw.
Yes! It was tub-thumping, crowd-pleasing, great fun. Liked it.
I don't know if the Queen is going to like you, but I think William and Harry are going to love you.
It's been a long, long time I have seen anything in this country so fresh, so exciting. And what I really like about you guys is I think you are incredible role models for this country.
Definitely.
As well. Now, the important part. Piers.
Yes.
Amanda.
Definitely yes.
Yes.
Okay. Guys, you're through to the next round.
Come on, well done, guys. Congratulations. I love the fact that you've done that routine and then when they said you can go through to celebrate, you started dancing again.
Yeah. Every second, as soon as that music is going, that's it, man. And give us some touch, man. Respect.
No problem. Welcome back to Britain's Got Talent, where every single act wants to appear at the Royal Variety Performance and impress the Queen.
But before they can do that, they have to get past the judges.
Next to face the panel are best friends Luke and Charlotte.
Oh, they're pouring faster! My favourite!
How long have you been partners?
6 months.
6 months. Do you get on? Do you like each other?
Yes.
Do you ever have any arguments?
A little.
Okay. Lovely. All right, ready okay. to go.
Is so precise and so disciplined. I think you're fantastic.
Thank you.
I thought I was going to absolutely loathe that, but actually, you're very good. I think the British public are going to like you. Yeah, I do.
I thought you were great, yes.
Yes.
Guys, you're through to the next round.
Congratulations, you two! How'd you feel?
Really pleased.
Are you crying because you're happy? I hope you're crying because you're happy. You were fantastic out there. And they said that you looked really sharp together. Do you feel it went well?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, you pleased.
Yeah.
This competition is open to anyone of any age. And here to represent the older generation
is 70-year-old Norma.
Norma?
Yes, hello, sweetheart. How
lovely
are you?
To see you. Very
thank
good,
you, my
thank
darling.
You.
My name is Norma, and I'm a rapper. And I'm a 70-year-old woman, and the idea of actually doing this is to bridge the gap between the young and the old. I've been rapping for roughly 7 to 8 years.
Do you write your own raps?
I write my own raps. Maybe I could be maybe one of the oldest rappers in the world. I don't know. When you hear me say, ladies and gentlemen, I give you old and past it.
It's it.
That's the one. That's the cue.
Well done!
Can I ask, what's your name?
Yes, my name is Norma Clark.
Norma.
Yes.
I don't normally allow the boys to ask this, but how old are you?
I'm 70.
Wow! What is it that you do?
I'm into rap. Forget about my age, it's what the body does.
Good for her. Go on, Norma. Off you go.
I give you old and past it. I
inside the store. The crowd gathered round and yelled for more. My body was a popping, went from a shop. A voice called stop, I'll call a cop. I ain't doing nothing, earning bread. I got no food and I need a bed. The crowd like me, spinning on the floor. He said, move yourself from my store. Me man, no man, do your ear. Just get your ass into first gear. Yeah. Oh yeah.
Norma, I'm really impressed. I'm impressed because you remembered all those words. I couldn't remember any of that at my age.
Well, I should remember them, sweetheart. I wrote them.
Norma, you might be old, but you're not past it.
No.
I think you're a great inspiration.
Thank you.
Simon.
I couldn't disagree more. I think there are certain things ladies of your age shouldn't be doing, and that. And the purpose of this show is to find an act to perform in front of the royal family. And I think they would be quite upset if
I
it was you.
I think Your Majesty would be quite amused.
No, I disagree. Well, amused maybe, happy no.
OK, so Piers, what's your answer?
Yes.
Yeah. A resounding no.
I'm going to say yes.
Have you gone completely nuts?
Congratulations, well done.
Congratulations. Hey. So Norma's hidden talent has finally been discovered.
And she's just one of the gems that's being unearthed today.
Yes from me.
Yes from me.
You're through to the next round.
Yes.
I'm losing sleep over you.
Definitely yes.
It's proven to be a talent-filled day, but no one's taken any chances backstage where there's lots of last-minute practice going on.
Can the next contestant keep the run of success alive? It's 14-year-old Dominic from Walsall.
Hello. You all right?
I'm fine, thank you.
Hi, Jan. You all right?
What are you doing for us today?
Well, I'm going to sing Unchained Melody.
Oh, brilliant. So you're a singer?
Yes.
How long have you been singing?
I've been singing for about nearly 4 years now.
And how old are you now?
I'm 14.
14. Do you think you can win this competition?
I could have a good whack at it.
A good whack at it.
I like that.
With Dad watching anxiously in the wings, it's time for Dominic's big moment.
Okay, what's your name, young man?
Dominic Smith.
What do you do, Dominic?
I sing.
Okay, so it means a lot to you, this, yeah?
Yeah, it really does.
Let's see what you've got, then.
Thank you.
Whoa, my love, my darling, I've hungered for your touch a long, lonely time, and time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. Are you still
one buzz.
Dominic, we've had to sit through stuff that's really caused us to lose the will to live, and you have just restored my faith in Birmingham.
It's like you told me the story of that song. I listened to every word, and for a boy your age, I find that astounding.
Dominic, don't know how many times I've heard that version of Unchained Melody. I have to say, I thought you were amazing. Here's yes or no.
Definitely yes.
Amanda?
Yes.
You are sailing through to the next round.
How'd you feel?
I feel great. Fantastic.
You enjoy that?
It was the best. Really was. And that Simon Cowell was like complimenting me. Oh, wow. It was wicked.
Dominic, oh my God, he just blew me away. I really did get goosebumps when he started singing.
I think that he's a potential real star. He's got everything. I mean, a lovely voice.
I think he's fantastic. Under any circumstance, this guy was a great singer.
Welcome back to Britain's Got Talent. So the judges have all left London and arrived here in Manchester to carry on the search for an act fit for the Queen.
The acts are ready. The judges have arrived. Hello. So, let's get on with it.
Don't you think you're forgetting something, Ant?
I think I've thought of everything. Deck.
Audience.
Just gonna make a quick call.
Yeah.
So, with the audience now in place, let the auditions in Manchester continue.
Britain's Got Talent.
Arriving outside and hoping for a perfect start to the day are Jackie, Bertie and Asia, who together form poetry trio Catalyst.
Hello there.
Hello.
Can we have a chat?
Yes.
Lovely. I'll grab a seat next to you.
Who have we got here? What's your name?
Jackie.
Jackie, hello Jackie, nice to meet you. And who have we got here down on the floor?
We've got... This big chap's Bertie.
And who's that one?
That's
Aisha.
Aisha. And are these your only two?
No, I have several others.
Do you? How many?
Several?
Several, yes.
How many?
Oh, I'm down to 11 now.
Wow. 11. So you sit in the middle and then we've got the cats, and then you read...
I recite.
That is something you wrote?
Yes.
And the cats just sit
there?
They
sit there.
Okay. It's time to see if Catalyst will get a good reaction, and somehow we've been roped in to help out.
Why don't you just stick his claws in there?
What?
You go there, you birdies. Had to get somebody to carry my pussy for me.
And Dex's always happy to do that.
What's your name?
The actor's called Catalyst.
Okay.
And I'm Jackie. I started writing verse last autumn, but I felt, as a standalone, it probably wasn't good enough.
Oh, no. How did I get roped into this?
Come here.
Can I just sum this up, what the act is, because I'm not absolutely clear?
This is like a bad dream.
What's the act?
Pussies and poetry, is it?
Well, you'll see in a minute, we've got to get back off!
All right, OK.
OK. I think okay. We ought to get on with this, because, right.
Okay.
Could you put that under my... underneath?
Put that under your bum. There you are. Okay. Are you quite happy now?
I'm more than happy, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
What was all that about?
Your cat didn't want to stay there, did it?
No.
allow me to introduce my props. They're not like a cane, stool or hat. Here's Bertie.
Look at that cat looking at you.
Simon.
Jackie, it was sort of ridiculous. It's you with two cats who don't want to be there reading a poem about a cat.
When you put it like that.
Well, no, it isn't a poem about a cat. It was an introduction, and then I was moving on to verse.
But what's the point of the cats? Jackie, they're not going to pay any interest, are they?
Well, they were earlier.
They just sat on your...
Sorry. Are you sitting on your cat, or...?
No, she's behind me. She's
right.
Behind.
Simon, yes or no?
No.
It's a no from me.
It's a no.
Well, what are you going to do now? What happens now?
Move.
But with the act?
Is it no,
Bango's live tour.
Sorry.
Look at that. Cat hairs, that's what that is. Stupid.
So it's a no for Jackie and her pussies. And as the judges see more and more animals throughout the auditions, things don't get any better.
Oh, ooby-doo, I want to be like you. Ooby-doo, I want to walk like you. Chick-pop like you, you see it true.
It didn't look like dancing.
Do you think the Queen would be ready for your budgies?
Well, if she doesn't mind a bit of bird poo, that would be great, yeah.
Punches it flew into the audience.
We can't take the risk, Don, of one of your birds attacking the Queen. That's the problem.
Worst dog actor I've ever seen.
David, even Jenny has left the stage in embarrassment. Okay?
Jenny stitched him right up.
What do you do?
I dance with my partner.
She's kissing him. Did you just kiss it then? Did you just kiss it then? Did you?
I thought it was a bit pony, to be honest.
Just weird.
Weird, but very good.
It's not going well for our four-legged friends, but hoping to turn the tide, our 11 ladies from Lincolnshire.
We're girls, we're the canines!
Oh, yeah. What are you here to do today?
We're here to dance with our dogs. We're going to do a line dancing with the dogs.
Okay.
You know, they say the owners of pets start to look like their animals. None of them look like their pets.
And do you think you can win, girls?
Oh, definitely. Yeah, definitely.
Ready when you are. I've been married a long time ago.
Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Katnado? This dog's line dancing. I've been married a long time ago.
Where did you come from? Where did you go? Back up.
And clips.
Sit.
That one's not doing... It's not doing anything.
I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Katnado?
Okay, Piers.
Absolutely not. Pointless. No.
Amanda.
I'm going to say yes.
All right, we're going to go through you now. Stan and Simon.
Right, girls, reality check. The choreography was hideous, the costumes didn't work. You've got a major problem with three of your dogs. I think we need a bit of work with... I think we need a bit of work with the choreography. But there's potential. My answer is, it's a yes.
Well done.
disobedient dogs.
No, they weren't that disobedient.
I think, they didn't do anything.
No, I think the audience at home would like them.
It's a talent show, not crafts.
What? Someone like me.
Backstage, hoping to carry on the run of success just like our four-legged friends, is 29-year-old beauty therapist Victoria,
who's going to give it one last shot at the big time.
My act is an angle grinder which cuts steel. I put a metal disc onto the grinder and I wear a metal thong and then chip it so it sends sparks. It's the adrenaline I like. It's the, you know, when you're on stage, it is a natural high. Up until 13 months ago, I was doing it week in, week out, and then I gave it up and set up a new spray tanning business for the simple reason I wanted to be at home more with my son. I was away a lot all the time, and it's hard, isn't it?
Hello.
Hi.
Why are you here?
I'm here to do maybe my last grinder show.
A grinder show?
Yeah.
Right, I've never seen one of those. What is it?
It's sends sparks in the sky.
Okay, and you think you can win?
Yeah. Yeah.
Good.
Why not?
Okay.
Thank you.
Good.
Can we have the lights down, please? Thank you.
Are you doing anything for dinner tonight? I thought that was absolutely hilarious. Loved it. Very sexy, very funny, completely unique. I mean, I've got to ask you, at what point of your life did you wake up and think, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to do that.
I was podium dancing one night and they offered more money for stilt walking, fire eating, angle grinding, 300 quid. I thought, wait, I'm in there. I learned that in my back garden.
In your back garden.
All right, Piers, yes or no?
I think it's safe to say I'd like to see a lot more of you, Victoria, so yes.
Thank you.
Amanda.
Definitely a yes.
You have the likability factor. The answer is yes. Turn me off.
Oh, thank you.
How good was that?
Very, very.
So the minute she walked,
she was. She looks. Yeah, she looked great.
Oh my God. Hey, they didn't even press the buzzer.
Welcome back to Britain's Got Talent, where already tonight there have been some astonishing performances.
I have been good, haven't I?
There's a load more acts arriving outside, hoping to turn their dreams into a reality.
Among them are an illusionist duo with big ambitions. It's a kind of magic.
It's a kind of magic. Together, Wayne and Jenny form the husband and wife team that are Genesis. It's a kind of
magic. Hello, you two.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Hello.
Wayne, sorry, mate.
Wayne?
This is Jenny.
Hi, Jenny. Nice to meet
Jenny.
You. I've been doing illusions for 9 years now altogether, and 4 years with Wayne.
And what's your relationship with you guys?
Married.
Are you married?
Husband, wife, yeah. We've not long been seeing each other, and we were both stuck for work. So I said to Jen, you know, what we're going to do? And Jen said, well, I need an illusionist. And I said, oh, well, just give me a go. I said, you know, it can't be that hard. I said, just give me... She says, no, Wayne, you're a mechanic. I says, I'll be right, just give us a go. So she gave me a go, and here we are, so...
That's yeah, really good as well. It's not done bad to say I was a mechanic.
Where's good. The missus?
No idea.
We'll leave it there, shall we? Let's get you in.
Have a good one.
Cheers. Hello there, how you doing? What's your name? Wayne Owen.
Okay, and the name of the act?
Genesis.
Genesis, okay, yeah. And it's a magic act, obviously.
Yeah, there is a magic act, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Let's see your stuff.
Thank you very much.
He looks quite scary, doesn't he?
He's angry.
He does. I didn't expect that dancing.
No. I don't think the audience did either.
Good illusion. Still not keen on his jacket. Looks like he works on the motorways.
Well, it was a very good trick. I'm going to give you that. I have no idea how you did it. I have two negatives. Number one is the weird faces you pull. I didn't get that.
Oh, you can smile.
Secondly, the crazy dancing at the end. I don't understand that. Whose idea was it to do the dancing?
Mine! I like dancing!
Alright, okay. Amanda, do you like the dancing?
No, I completely agree with Simon. It was kind of like Strictly Come Dancing magic just at the end. But I thought the trick was brilliant. You impressed me, it was good.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I think that you've got to lose this aggressive thing.
Yeah, you're scary.
But I think in terms of the trick, great. Simon, yes or no?
Based on the trick, yes.
Thank you very much.
I agree totally with Simon. Yes.
You're through to the next round?
Did you do that off stage?
Thank you very much.
How did they do it?
I have no idea. Can she fit into that little thing?
Well, it must be.
It's an illusion box, so she's already in there.
Well, obviously.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Buzzing. Absolutely buzzing.
So, Genesis tricked their way past the judges, and it's proven to be a show-stopping afternoon.
You are through to the next round.
Well done. Oh, I like this celebration.
Stephen Sparks Williams, you are through to the next round.
Brilliant.
I will follow him. Follow him wherever he.
Yes for me.
And yes for me.
So the Manchester auditions are drawing to a close.
But there's one last contestant hoping that this moment could change his life.
My name is Mike, I'm 37 and I'm a comedy impressionist. My day job, I'm a driving instructor, believe it or not. I perform sporadically, mainly just to my pupils in the car that I'm teaching to drive on a one-to-one basis.
And it's not just his pupils who would love to see Mike fulfil his dreams.
My dad used to perform on the Northern Club circuit. He's a very good comedian, and when I've watched him, particularly as a kid and a teenager, I've picked up a few good habits from him. Very talented man. Fortunately, doesn't do it anymore now because he's got on a little bit and he's got Parkinson's. I guess I'd like to do it for my dad, really, make him proud.
Hi there.
Heather.
What's your name?
It's Mike.
What is your talent?
I am a comedy impressionist.
Okay. How long have you done that?
I think I first started doing impressions when I was at school, so it's a good few years.
What was your sort of inspiration for all this?
My dad, he used to be a very popular comedy, comedian, singer. He used to do the Clubland circuit, but he's getting on a bit now. He can't do it anymore now.
Well, he's retired, is he?
He's got Parkinson's, so he can't do it anymore.
So what would it mean to you, to him, do you think, if you were to make it to the Royal Variety Show?
I don't know. I'd like to see his reaction. I'd like to see.
Do you
his
feel
reaction.
Like, in a funny way, you're sort of carrying his baton,
his mantle, if you like? Yeah, yeah. I'd like to think so. It would be good.
Right.
Good luck.
Okay. 3, 2, 1.
Hello, I'm Chris Turner. Welcome back to Who Wants to Be. Welcome back to Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, where our contestant David Beckham is currently on £100. He's used 2 lifelines. And he's about to use his 3rd lifeline, his phone a friend. So, David, who are we going to ring?
Well, it's a pretty tricky question, so I think I'll ring Tony Blair.
Hi, Prime Minister Tony Blair here, of
yes,
course.
He looks like Tony Blair when he comes
out. Currently Prime Minister, of course. How can I help?
Right, well, the question is, who is currently the Prime Minister? Is it A, Tony Blair, B, Lionel Blair, C, the Blair Witch Project, or D, Del Boy Trotter from Only Fools and Horses?
I don't think you need my help, David. I think the answer's pretty much staring you in the face.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, of course. It's D, Del Boy Trotter from Only Fools and Horses.
We sit here through hour after hour of often very mediocre stuff, I'll be honest with you, which can be quite soul-destroying, and then we just occasionally chat and say, wouldn't it be great if some guy just came on stage and blew us away? And you just blew us away.
I really did think you were very good, and I think you could give John Coleshaw a run for his money. Definitely.
Mike, one of the best impressionists I've ever heard. Really. I thought it was very funny, which is tough. I've got to tell you, Mike, I think your dad would be very proud of you. Okay. Here's yes or no.
Yes.
Amanda? Yes.
Thumbs up from me, it's a yes.
Mike, you're through. You can imagine that at the Royal Variety Show.
And he's likable.
Yeah. Very
yeah,
likable.
Really yeah, really sweet.
My father used to do this on the club circuit. He's never made it onto television. Just the thought of him being able to perhaps watch me on television, it's just waiting to see his reaction. I'm sure he'll be chuffed to bits, really will be.
Another day of auditions has come to a close, and as the audience heads home, it seems that Mike's left a lasting impression on the judges.
I like it on a show like this when you see normal people who don't do this full time have put together a decent act and it works. I prefer that. And actually, funny enough, I could see him on the Royal Variety. I genuinely could. And I could see him stealing the show, funny enough, from all the pros.
So that's it. It's time to say goodbye to Manchester.
We're heading back on the road now, as our motto says, wherever there is talent, we'll be there.
I thought our motto was, wherever there is free drink and complimentary sandwiches, we will be there.
That's it, yeah, that's the one. That's the one, oh, yeah.
Come on then. See you tomorrow.